My name is Andrew Spanyi. I live in the Niagara region, and I was a caregiver for my wife, Katalin, for over 2 decades as she fought cancer. Katalin was first diagnosed with breast cancer in 2003. She was only 42 at the time. We were both shocked. We knew nothing about cancer, so Katalin decided to follow the recommended standard treatment of surgery, chemotherapy, and radiation in 2003 and 2004. I cut back on my work, drove her to her treatments, and provided support 24/7. The chemotherapy and radiation treatments were invasive, highly toxic, and had several side effects, but they did do their job, and Katalin was cancer-free for over 11 years. Unfortunately, the cancer returned in 2016, and it had spread to the scalp and the bones. This time around, we were more planful. We had returned to the Niagara region in 2014 after Katalin had taken early retirement from her position as a marketing professor in Connecticut. So in addition to her local oncologist in Niagara, we were fortunate to still have access to her oncologist at UConn. The first line of treatment in 2016 was a hormonal medication, letrozole, recommended by both oncologists. This medication provided Katalin with progression-free survival for almost 2 years. But when a CT scan revealed minor disease progression, the next recommended treatment was a drug combination of Ibrance and Faslodex. These medications worked from 2018 to 2020. It was during this period that we sought out additional resources. We obtained second opinions from oncologists both at Sunnybrook Hospital in Toronto and Roswell Park in Buffalo. Katalin also ordered next generation sequencing, also known as NGS. The sequencing results revealed that targeting the PI3K pathway may be the most effective means of treating her cancer. We discovered a suitable clinical trial through a second opinion consult at Sunnybrook Hospital in Toronto. As I reflect on our experience during those 4 years, I think we did a few things well. Our habit of asking a lot of probing questions, seeking out highly respected oncologists for second opinions, and arranging for next generation sequencing of her tumor all contributed to finding the right next treatment. Katalin was accepted into a clinical trial that targeted the PI3K pathway in June of 2020, and this trial provided progression-free survival for well over 2 years. Once she was released from the trial, we went back to review the results of the NGS and consulted with two oncologists on the next best treatments. Both recommended a drug that treated Katalin's hormone-positive and HER2-negative cancer by inhibiting mTOR. And these medications worked until July of 2023. However, at that time, a CT scan revealed that the disease had progressed further to her lungs. She passed away just a few months later. She had fought long and hard, and I think that our practice of asking a lot of probing questions, seeking out highly respected oncologists for second opinions, and ordering next generation sequencing to facilitate precision medicine did make a difference. Now, resources such as Cancer Patient Lab are vital in so much as they help us to ask better questions. Thank you for your attention.